guys. Just a tribute to you know who. So, you know, I'm real busy now. I've got like a 12-hour day. I'm just like, but you know, I'm real responsible. So I thought I'd come here and tell you what I think about this, this you-know-who business. And let me tell you something. My little old hound here, she could pick up what that dog said. And let me tell you, she's got so much to say about it. Right, darling?
Yeah. You know, I was talking to the dog and I got inside information. And you know what the dog told me? He said that he did it. And he said that he actually gave him a sausage. And that's how he got away with it. The dog, he didn't know. And then when he found out, you know, he wanted to tell the police dogs, but they just didn't want to listen to him. It's really not fair, you know? It's not fair because, you know, the dog said he would have done something, but they just didn't listen to him.
Yeah, folks, there I am doing, like, everything to get you inside information. Let me tell you, folks, that's a lot of work. You know, we YouTubers, we work so hard to get the information. You know how hard it is to get into YouTube and to click? You know, it takes time to go into the internet and get information from Google and all that. And you know, I've got my inside information from the sheriff, you know. I shouldn't tell anybody. So that takes a lot of work. So you guys, you don't appreciate us. Because, you know, I'm such a selfless person. I'm just doing it because I want the truth to come out. It's not because I enjoy talking about it. I don't enjoy talking about how that little tiny hole where they shoved the body and he had to break the bones. And the reason I go into all those details is because it's so important to tell all the details. And, you know, if you're squeamish, you turn this video right now. Because not everybody can be that. Not everybody has my, I'm tough. I'm tough as nails. You know, I worked in a slaughterhouse. So for me, it's easy to talk about these things. You know, I also worked in the Piggly Wiggly for a long time. And when you work in the Piggly Wiggly, Mississippi, you've seen everything, man. Everything. So I'm toughened up. I'm tough as nails. But for those of you viewers out there who can't take it, turn off the video right now. And I want to tell you something. There's a crazy lady there and she's chasing me. I had to call the police on her. So, crazy lady, if you're listening there, I'm a professional. I know what a psychopath is, a narcissist. Because I Googled that. That was a lot of work and I've got a certification. I'm certified crazy. And, you know, and that's not easy. Not everybody can get that certification. So you watch out, crazy old lady, that writing me all those mean things. You be careful. You watch your mouth, lady, because this is a good Christian home right here. So you watch it. You watch it, because I got some people that can meet your people, and they can take it outside, and you'll be sorry. You'll be cursing the day you ever wrote that mean comment on my YouTube channel. So you be careful. It's not about me. It's not about me, it's about the victim. We've got to expose the truth so everybody will know and feel real good they have a good old husband who doesn't do that to them. And it's not domestic violence. No, it's not. That guy was a psychopath. I mean, look at me. When I married my husband, you know what I wanted to know? I want to know, can you dance? And when he could say, yeah, I can dance. That's it. That's the quality I looked for. And, you know, a person who can dance can't be a psychopath. That's clear. So me and my little old hound here, you know, we've been snooping around. But it's not for me. It's because I don't have anything to do. I've got 12-hour day ahead of me. Do you know what it's like? I've got to drive 7 hours. 7 hours I've got to And I work with people. I work with people, and I know what it means, you know? Piggly Wiggly is not an easy place to work at, you know? I'm doing it just for you and for that victim of that crime, because I got a heart out there for her. It's not about me. Hey, and you crazy lady out there, you better watch it. Because I called the other YouTuber. I heard you wrote a mean comment on her YouTube as well. So you better watch your ass. So listen to it. It's not about domestic violence. Because that no way a man could do this to his wife. No way he did it, because he's a psychopath loony. And I know all about it. I can diagnose a guy because I work in a Piggly Wiggly 12-hour straight shifts. And I can tell you, anybody who works in a Piggly Wiggly, they've seen everything. They've seen everything. Yeah, I tend to repeat myself because, you know, it's not easy to do this work. You know, I got to take time off my busy schedule, lay in bed here, and say all these things and comment to every stupid comment anybody makes. And, you know, I want to tell you, bless that heart, that YouTuber. I love the ones with the British accent, because, you know, the British Empire has done mighty good to the world. They've been great. I mean, if it wasn't for the British Empire, there wouldn't have been the potato famine, and my ancestors wouldn't have got out of Ireland and came all the way over here. And now I'm an American, and I'm proud to be an American. And yeah. And we got a mighty good president now. He's mighty good role model to all those men, you know? Because he's really good. You just watch our president, how he treats women is really good. Because you watch him and how he paid all those strippers. You know, he paid them good money not to tell that story. That's a good man out there. You got a good man there in the White House, making sure the White House remains white. Sometimes we give a little slack. And about my comment about you-know-who being like a concentration camp survivor, that had nothing to do with the Jews, you know. I love the Jews, you know. I actually organized with the church. We went, yep, we organized the trip, and we went up to New York. Because, you know, New York has so many Jews, and we were just sitting there in a park and looking at Jews, and nobody could say anything bad about them, you know? I once knew a Jew. There was once a Jew here, but I don't know, he kind of moved out after they burned that cross over his lawn. Yeah, I don't know why that happened. It happened a long time ago, but let me tell you, I always say good morning to him, even though, you know, there's these crazy loonies around here. Especially in the Piggly Wigglies, you got to watch out for those. So let me tell you, folks, it's hard work doing YouTube. It's hard work, and people just don't appreciate it, huh?
No, they don't appreciate you, Mommy. You're such a good heart, and you're so good to me. And you know, if you want, I will talk about all the things I heard from the dog. I can tell you everything.
So you just know I've got inside information here. This dog here, if she could talk, she tell you so much, and we understand each other. You heard her talk. I've got a special communication with animals, you know? And let me tell you, I'm going to get you subscribe to my channel and give me a like, because I'll tell you, yeah, this here was somebody not so nice and a Piggly Wiggly. It was sort of like it had a bad day. But let me tell you, there was not domestic violence. No, it wasn't. And let me tell you, this dog, she's going to tell a lot of things. So you better subscribe to my channel, because I'm going to have a lot of information from you. This other YouTuber, she's got inside information about the jail. And we're going to go in all the details about the murder, crushed bones. Because, you know, I just have a heart for the victims, which is why I keep telling you all about how they died, this horrible deaths. Because, you know, that's really important for us. Because God knows, we need to talk more about how the murder was done. So all of you out there in your homes, you can have a nice supper, Sunday supper with your man. And you say, wow, thank God I'm not married to him.